untold smiles, a break from textbooks and tests. Children need to be emotionally and socially superior to tread on today's world and living. Education needs to support this. Field trips, which explore the environment, enhances first-hand experience of the child.
किसी भी बस्ती में किसी खेत में या जरा सा पानी रहेगा खाली बावड़ी रहेगी नदी रहेगी उसके पास कहीं भी दिखने वाला सांप है
कैन देयर बी अ चेंज इन द सिस्टम आउटडोर एजुकेशन कैन बी एन अल्टरनेटिव टू द एज ओल्ड गुरुकुल सिस्टम. It can provide as an aid to the existing education system.
I think the purpose of outdoor education goes far beyond just being in the outdoors. What it really talks about is an approach to learning. Learning could be it could be schooling, it could be college, it could be way beyond. So outdoor education doesn't really stop at working with young people. It goes beyond to an whole approach to life.
You might like to now, having learned something from there.
Learning in the outdoor is active, cooperative, and relevant. One of the underlined aim of a curriculum must be to prepare children for opportunities and experience of adult life. A relevant, direct experience is a benefit to any area of study.
I like science, but actually I feel that science should be taught to us, not in the classroom, but in nature, in the surroundings, so we can know things better.
They should keep such kind of trips, so it can encourage the students and make them a little more adventurous and close to nature or something.
Nature, natural environment, open spaces, no books, no heavy bags. Outdoor education is said to provide a vehicle of change and development. Can teaching then hold significance? A clear understanding of why activities are performed is essential.
The framework that we create during a program gives them an opportunity to encounter things like planning, decision making, learning to handle fear, learning to handle stress, learning to handle change, communication, working together. And the way we do it is we have exercises where we give them instructions and we give them a format and we say that this is what you're supposed to do and these are the props available, this is the problem, and solve it.
Adventure is a great motivator. Young people who underachieve in the classroom may suddenly come up alive and show a range of skills that have remained dormant in the formal teaching. Children enjoy a common experience that brings them together. There is a sense of achievement, participation, and belonging.
In schools where I teach English and history, we have found that the students have a sense of inadequacy, that they cannot go beyond a certain level of success. It is that sense we have helped them overcome in this program, because we goad them to do something that might be a wee bit beyond their estimated capacity. So they put in that very little more and achieve success, which gives them a lot of confidence that if you put in the right effort, success is yours.
Success is what we always emphasize on. Get good marks, be a topper. But this kind of an approach says that you can achieve success through virtue by doing the activity well.
For us, success is not so important. And we try and get that across through our facilitation method, that it's possible for you to be successful by virtue of just doing the activity well. You may not have been able to finish it, you may have taken more time, you may not have been able to finish it within time if the rules were strict and stress was created for that group, but the fact that they were able to work together, communicate well, get things right, that's it. That's what success is all about. It isn't about finishing first. It's about learning a process.
There is a place in education to put the student in the situation of perceived risk and teaching them how to cope with it.
Are you ready?
Yes!
Falling!
Fall on!
Risk-taking is one important part of living and learning through experience. But the schools today train children for 10 years in don't take a chance attitude. Thus, the young generation does not take a step out of its protective shell to do things that involve risk.
Well, risk really is venturing into the unknown. And what we do here is make people do a lot of things that they don't know anything about and enjoy it hugely and get the confidence that even if you don't know something, you can still master it. I think the parallel between this and the education process is reasonably obvious because education is all about getting to grips with what you don't know. I think the confidence that people get in this exercise enables them to crack any known subject, unknown subject with ease.
With so much of risk and adventure, safety becomes important. It makes children think of the safety aspects, whether physical or emotional.
The safety systems that we follow ensure that physical safety is almost guaranteed. I mean, everybody is harnessed. Nobody will do any move which might involve a fall, for example. What we deal with more than physical safety is up here. We deal with emotional safety. Even when you know that you are completely safe physically, you can still feel scared. And that is all a mental process and it's all an emotional thing. And this entire process of adventure programming enables you to crack that problem.
Risk-taking, dealing with fears and emotions, teamwork is all a part of feelings. But can Outdoor incorporate the actual syllabus of the school's curriculum? Through activities, the Outdoor educators incorporate the syllabus, which not only happens at a recreational level, but also at the understanding of facts.
Take the A-frame, for example. First of all, it's a fun activity, and fun is a very important element of everything that we do. It requires support, which means that it is a team activity. It uses knowledge of fulcrums and levers from physics. You require technique rather than strength to do the activity, because it means you have to lean back and then twist the thing, and the timing has to be right. And everybody has to be working together. They must know which string to pull, which not to pull, which to leave slack. And it uses all those elements, the typical elements of all the activities that we have. Yet, it can remain as an activity in itself and remain at the recreational level. We don't let it go at that. That's probably the difference between the A-frame being used for recreation and for development. We take it beyond that to what we call a reviewing process, in which we talk about what is it that they have learned in the activity. It had to do with the facts of the activity, the feelings of the activity, and they discovered something in the process. Now we put that together in the review process and then ask them how they can apply it and take it back to their future.
Children take their own responsibility for their own learning. Such a setup has contributed immensely in the field of academics. The students take back to their homes and schools a lot of things.
Really fantastic here, and to have an experience of this, it's really good.
We've learned to trust our friends in a better way and understand them much better.
In the nature trail we saw quite a few birds and learned about we learned sound, how the birds, the sound of the birds, and we even learned about quite a few different plants. It's learning with fun.
I've learned to eat almost everything, and I think my parents are really going to be very satisfied.
If these activities were brought into school, I think school would be a much better place.
If a man is hungry, you give him a fish, you feed him. If you show him how to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. This is what experiential learning is all about.